Hello everyone, myself J. Vinay Kumar. Today the subject which I'm going to deal is DC machines and batteries. In the previous presentation, we have already discussed about the various performance goals of DC motors and we have already discussed about the brake test on DC motors. And we have also learned about the efficiency of the DC motor. In this presentation, we are going to learn about the Swinburne's test. This Swinburne test is a simple indirect test or method which is also called as no load test or losses method. Since there is no load, we call this as the no load test. In this method, the various losses are measured separately and the efficiency at any desired load can be predetermined in advance. And this method is applicable to those machines which has the flux as constant, that is practically constant. Such motors are, such machines are the shunt and the compound wound machines. In these machines, the flux will be almost constant. So we perform this Swinburne's test on these machines. Here you can see the circuit diagram for a Swinburne test. Here we are applying DC supply to the machine. And this A1 and A2 are the ammeters to know the current flowing in that particular circuit. And here A and AA is the armature terminals, and this Z and ZZ is nothing but it is the shunt field winding, and R represents a rheostat. And here I naught is nothing but it is the no load current. This machine run as a motor on no load at its rated voltage. The speed of this machine can be adjusted to the rated speed with the help of a shunt regulator. And here the no load current I naught is measured by the ammeter A1. And the shunt field current ISS is measured by ammeter A2. And the no load armature current is I0 minus ISH. आर आई ये वो लेट द सप्लाई वोल्टेज अप्लाइड टू द मशीन इज वी वोल्ट्स एंड द नो लोड करंट is 0 and the no load input is equal to V into I naught. The shunt field current is given as I S H. The power input to the armature is V into IA or V into I naught minus I SH. The power input to the shunt field winding is V into I S H. Here the no load power input to the armature supplies the following iron losses in the core and friction and windage losses and also this no load power input supplies the armature copper loss which is given as I naught minus I S H square into R A or I A naught square into R A. And if we subtract The no load armature copper loss from the total input, we get the constant losses. And these constant losses WC is equal to V into I naught minus I naught minus ISH whole square into RA. We know that V is the supply voltage, I naught is the no load current, I naught minus ISH is the current flowing in the armature, and RA is the armature resistance. Now, if we know the constant losses of the machine, then its efficiency at any load can be determined. Let IL is the load current at which efficiency is required. The armature current is IA is equal to IL minus ISH if the machine is acting as a, that is, if the machine is running as a motor, and if the machine is working as a generator, then the load current IL is equal to I plus ISH. Now let us see the efficiency when the machine is running as a motor. The motor input is equal to V into IL, where V is the supply voltage and IL is the load current. Then the armature copper losses is equal to IA square RA. where Ia is equal to IL minus ISH. So the armature copper loss is equal to IL minus ISH whole square into RA. And to get the constant losses, which is represented by WC, we have to subtract the armature copper losses from the no load input, that is V into I naught minus IL minus ISH whole square into RA. Your I naught is the no load current. Now to get the total losses, we should add the armature copper losses with the constant losses represented by WC. So the total losses is equal to I minus ISH whole square into RA plus WC, that is the constant losses. So to get the efficiency of a motor is nothing but it is the ratio of output to the input of a motor. Here output can be written as input minus total losses. So the efficiency of motor is equal to input minus total losses by input. So if we write this in equation form, then we get the efficiency of the motor is equal to voltage into current VI minus I minus ISH whole square here it is a mistake. I minus ISH whole square into RA minus W C by V I, that is the input. Now we'll see the efficiency of a machine when it is running as a generator. Here the output is equal to V into I, that is the product of voltage and current, and the armature copper loss is equal to I plus ISH whole square into RA. This I plus ISH is nothing but it is the armature current represented by IA. The constant losses WC is equal to V into I naught minus I naught plus ISH whole square into RA. Now the total losses is nothing but it is the sum of armature copper losses and constant losses. So total losses is equal to I plus ISH whole square into RA plus WC. But WC is nothing but it is the constant losses. Now to get the efficiency of a generator, we know that it is the ratio of output to input. Here the input for a generator can be written as output plus losses. So the efficiency of a generator is equal to output by output plus losses. If we substitute all the equations, then we get the efficiency of a generator as VI by VI plus I plus ISH whole square into RA plus constant losses represented by WC. In this way, we can find the efficiency of a DC generator. Now, let us see the advantages of Swinburne's test. This test is convenient and economical because power required to test a large machine is small, that is no load input power. And the efficiency can be predetermined at any load. Because constant losses are known. And the disadvantages of this Swinburne's test is here no account is taken of the change in iron losses from no load to full load. As the full load is due to armature reaction flux is distorted, which increases the iron losses in some cases by as much as 50%. And as the test is on no load, it is impossible to know whether commutation would be satisfactory at full load and whether the temperature rise would be within the specified limits. Take a break for 2 minutes. Afterwards, we will be going to the quiz part. Okay, now let us see a small quiz on this presentation. The first question is, the Swinburne's test is done on option A, DC series motor, option B, DC shunt motor, option C, induction motor, option D is none of the above. This is Swinburne's test. is always done on a constant flux machine, which we have already discussed in the presentation. That is a shunt motor, DC shunt motor. So the answer is DC shunt motor. The option is B. Now let us see the next one. The Swinburne's test is also called as option A, no load test, option B, load test, option C, both A and B, and option D, none of the above. The Swinburne's test is also called as a no load test, because we perform this test without any load connected to the machine, DC machine. So we call it as a no load test. So the option is A, no load test. Now let us see some frequently asked questions from this presentation. That is, first question is, derive an equation to determine the efficiency of a DC machine running as a motor by conducting a Swinburne's test. And the second question is, determine an equation derive an equation to determine the efficiency of a DC machine running as a generator by conducting Swinburne's test. Means once the machine running as a motor, and next one is the machine running as a generator. And this topic is very, very much important for diploma students. Thank you very much for listening this presentation with patience.